Cool. Hello everyone. I'm Albin Suresh. I'm a lead engineer here at Software AG, currently working on this ThinEdge project. With this presentation, I'll be showing you how you can monitor your IoT edge devices from any connected cloud platform. Okay, so why would you want to monitor your IoT edge devices, right? So these edge devices gives connectivity, like enables connectivity for your field devices and sensors to the cloud. Okay, so there are several services and everything running on it to enable this connectivity. And then typically you will have more applications or services running on the same device, which will be some analytical applications or machine learning applications, which is processing all the data that's collected by these devices, okay, and locally processing them to take some corrective actions and so on. Okay, so there is a lot of compute demand on these devices. So even though these devices are constrained, these applications add to some compute demand. And to have an optimal performance, the compute requirements, the resource requirements of this application should never exceed the capacity of the device itself. Now, if any ROG process starts pushing the device beyond its limits, say overusing the CPU or like filling up the disk, which might cause a failure later on if the disk fills up. So we would want to avoid all these kinds of things, right? So how do you even know if something like this is going happening on a device that's deployed on the field? Right? So how do you know what the CPU usage on the system is or what the disk usage on the system is, right? The solution is monitor it from the cloud, right? So before we get into details of monitoring, let's go back to my edge device here. Okay. I hope you can see my device screen. Okay. So here I've got a IoT edge device, and when an IoT device, so applications are running on IoT edge devices, if you want to monitor the resource usage of the device itself, many tools are available. So you have fancy tools like HTOP in this case, okay, which lets you monitor the CPU usage, the memory usage, and even process level usage of applications. So the resources, you can visualize it from here. It would have been nice if a similar visualization was possible from the cloud, right? So that you don't have to log into the device, but you can have a summarized overview of how your device is performing from the cloud itself, right? That's exactly what we have enabled with our monitoring solution, okay? So now if I head over to my Cumulocity cloud platform, to which this device that I showed you is connected, if you view the measurements, so the device was actually collecting some temperature simulator temperature measurements already. Okay. But along with that, it's actually monitoring the CPU, the disk usage of the root partition, and the memory usage as well. Okay. So you are actually getting a visual representation of your system's resource usages from the cloud. And this will be really critical when you are managing thousands and thousands of devices on the field. And you can do more with it. So since these measurements, like these metrics, are coming as measurements to this IoT cloud platform, you can probably even create alarms or something like that when one of these resources goes beyond a certain threshold. Say if the disk usage crosses 90%, and then you can define an alarm that will notify you when that happens, so that you can do some periodic maintenance to avoid an imminent failure. Okay. Now, heading back to the presentation. So what are the key challenges when you want to monitor your edge devices? Okay. So the first thing is that there will be many, many metrics that you would want to collect. So we already showed you a few: CPU, memory, disk, stats, and stuff like that. So there will be many more based on your deployment. You'd want to monitor some of your applications, external devices, services, et cetera, et cetera. So for every resource that you want to monitor, you will have to write some code to collect the metrics, the actual metrics from that resource, right? And then when your device is connected to a cloud platform, you would have to write some extra logic, some extra code to convert this native measurement data or raw measurement data into its cloud native format, so that those measurements can be sent as measurements to the cloud, to the connected cloud. And if you're working with multiple cloud vendors, then you allow to write the code for each and every, replicate this code for each and every cloud platform. Okay? So this pain of having to write code to whenever you want to monitor an extra data point and having to write this for each and every connected cloud platform, that's what we are trying to eliminate with our monitoring solution. Okay. So we'll show you how we have solved this problem with ThinHIO. Okay. So this is the same architectural slide that you have seen earlier, and I've highlighted the components relevant for monitoring in red color here. So there is this CollectD component. So CollectD is a very popular open source monitoring tool that's used by sysadmins for years. Okay. This tool supports monitoring of a lot of system resources, external applications, external services, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. So we have used CollectD as the monitoring tool. So this tool is the one that collects metrics from the system or external applications. Okay. And then CollectD will actually collect the stats and publish it to the local MQTT broker in a CollectD native format. Okay. And then we have our ThinEdge own device monitoring agent, which will consume these measurements collected by CollectD, published by CollectD, okay? And it will convert that, group those measurements together, and convert that into a ThinEdge JSON measurement format, which is locally well understood by ThinEdge processes, okay? So this device monitoring agent will convert these measurements into the ThinEdge JSON format, publish it back to the MQTT broker, so that those measurements, ThinEdge JSON measurements, are picked up by the data mappers for each connected cloud platform, and then it will be forwarded to the connected cloud. And the same data, which is available on the local broker, can be consumed by any of your third-party applications as well. So if you want to do some analytics on the system health metrics itself, you can do that, just like you have analytical applications on other measurements connected from other sensors connected to this edge device. Okay, so this is how we have enabled this monitoring solution. So as a customer, as a developer, all you have to do is, using CollectD, you just configure what you would like to monitor. Okay, just simple configurations, no code to be written. Just configure what you would like to collect, how often you would like to collect that metric, and then leave it at that. Then ThinEdge will do the rest of the heavy lifting for you. Okay, now let's head back to the device and see what's happening under the hood, and probably even try and see how you can extend the monitoring on a ThinEdge device. Okay. Now, going back to the device. So all the monitoring on ThinEdge device is actually defined in a CollectD configuration file. So this is the central configuration file for CollectD. And here, as you can see for the demo, I had already enabled a few data points. So here, this load plugin directive tells you to enable monitoring of CPU. And this DF plugin enables monitoring of disk usage. And here I've defined the interval as well. So CPU measurements are collected at 2 seconds, at 2 second intervals, disk measurements are collected at 4 second intervals, and so on. Okay. Now, if you try to visualize it, what CollectD is producing by listening to the local MQTT broker, you can see that you are getting individual measurement values for the metrics that you asked to collect. So there is the CPU, memory, and disk usage also. So everything is coming here, right? Now, these are individual measurements. For each metric that you collect, you will get individual measurement values, right? And now, if you head back, if you try to listen to TEDGE measurements topic, this is the topic to which our ThinEdge monitoring agent publishes the group measurements to. So if you listen to it, you will see that the same metrics that was published, that were published by CollectD, are actually grouped together by the monitoring agent. So here, in this case, the disk usage and CPU are grouped together, and in this case, memory and disk usage, and so on. So this process actually converts into the ThinEdge JSON. This is the ThinEdge JSON native form, ThinEdge JSON format. And this is the data that the cloud mappers or any other third-party tools can use to do any additional processing on. Okay. Now let's go back to the thin edge configuration and let's try to collect one more metric. Okay. So here I'm going to enable monitoring of the battery stats, so the battery usage of this device. Okay. So it's as simple as this. I just enable that particular battery plugin, which will start collecting the battery metrics. I save the configuration, and then I restart CollectD so that the updated configuration takes effect. And now, if you head back to the cloud platform and refresh, you should see the battery statistics appearing in addition to the, yeah, as you can see here, the battery stats are also appearing. Okay, the data, actually, yeah, it's 100% charge, so yeah, it's basically showing that particular metric right now. But yeah, as you saw, with just a plain and simple configuration, with one line of configuration, and without having to write any single line of code, you got to enable one more metric that could be monitored from the cloud. Okay. Now, one final question before we end this demo: why we chose CollectD? Okay, and the answer you probably would have noticed already in the CollectD configuration file. Okay, so CollectD supports monitoring of many metrics out of the box. Okay, so as you can see, there is battery, there is CPU, the things that we enabled already, but there is a long list of other plugins or other data points that you can collect your metrics from. So starting from this AD line number 88, AMQP, ACPFs, Crony, et cetera, et cetera. And if you keep scrolling down, you will see that it's a fairly long list. So swap memory. So there are many, many things that you can collect out of the box. So you just have to enable, so here till line number 220, nearly 140 plugins supported out of the box, which you can just enable just by a single line configuration change. And this was one of the, this extensibility was one of the primary reasons why we chose CollectD. Okay. And if you don't find a plugin appropriate out of the box, there are tons of other plugins available out there developed by the open source community, because CollectD has been there since 2005. It's been widely used in the open source community. So many people have written their own plugins for anything that's not really supported out of the box. So 99% of the time, you will find a plugin for what you want to monitor. And the other major reason why we chose CollectD was the low resource footprint that it has. Okay, so here, if you see, this is the resource usage by the CollectD process, the runtime resource usage. As you can see, the resident memory usage is just close to 5 megs of data and shared, so nearly 1 to 4 megs of runtime memory usage. That's the memory footprint. And if you try to see the disk usage, how much amount of how much data is actually stored on the disk. So you can see that this package is actually only like 199 KB of size. Okay. So with such a very minimal resource footprint, you are actually getting so much monitoring power. So that was one of the key points. Your monitoring system should not overwhelm the resource itself that it's monitoring, right? So that's one of the other reasons why we chose CollectD. Okay, so I hope this session was useful to you, and that's it from me.